Hello everyone, this is Brad Tallis with Next Gen Solutions, and welcome to Banter with Brad. In this series, I answer questions and topics sent to me from you, the viewers. I'll show different ways to approach the problem and share some tips and methods that hopefully will help you on your future projects. If you want your question or topic to appear on an upcoming episode of Banter with Brad, please email them to me at bradtallis@nextgensolutions.com. This episode's question comes from Lawrence C., and he asks, how can I create equally spaced holes that are the same distance from the edges? Well, let's take a look on how to do that. So I'm going to show a couple different methods on how you can accomplish this. I'm going to start by creating a quick sketch on my top view and doing a center rectangle. And I'm going to catch right in the middle. And I'm going to create a variable. So I'm going to type in length is equal to 6. And what that's going to do is create a parameter called length and set that to 6. And I could do the same thing here. I'll say height is equal to 0.75. And I'll create a circle in the center. Let's just say 0.25 in diameter. And then I'm going to use the rectangular pattern command. I'll go ahead and select the circle, start to drag so we can kind of visually see what's going on. I can increase the number. You can kind of see how it's going in that one direction. Well, I actually want it to go in both directions. So I'm going to go ahead and specify from one direction to symmetric. And now you can see that there's a circle in the center and then equally spaced holes going in each direction. And you'll notice it's set to spacing. Well, I don't know what the distance is or what it's supposed to be, but what I do know is the total length of my part. So I'm going to change spacing to extent. And now it's changing the distance. It's basically saying it's going 2.45 in one direction and 2.45 in the other. Well, I'm going to type in the word length and watch what happens when I start doing that. It allows me to pick it from the list, and you can see that it's going off the part. Okay. Well, that's because we're going symmetric and we only need to go half the distance of whatever length is. So I'm going to say length divided by 2. And now notice the result that we get. Okay. We get equally spaced holes. However, there's one on each end and I don't want those. So I'm going to go ahead and turn on this suppression. And that puts little check boxes on each of these holes. And I can suppress those two holes right there and say, okay. And we now have equally spaced holes that are the same distance from the edge. Now, there's pros and cons with this method. If I want to change this and come back and say, I want, like, for example, 9 holes, or actually let's do like 11, for example, it gets kind of confusing. You can kind of see the preview. I'll go ahead and hit OK, and you see the result that we get. So the holes that we originally turned off are still turned off, and then new holes, or circles, I should say, have appeared. So I'll go ahead and edit that. I'll do the suppression again, and just really quickly, I can turn on and turn off the ones that I want to keep or remove. I'll say OK, and we now have that solution there. So in this next example, we're going to go under the assumption that we don't want the circles to be centered. So I'm going to basically do the exact same thing. I'm going to start with a rectangle, and I'll type in length is equal to 6, and height is equal to 0.75. And then I'm going to go ahead and just create a circle off to the side here, and let's just make that 0.25 in diameter. Okay. The next thing I want to do is create a parameter called quantity. So I'm going to create a new parameter and let's just call it like QTY. Now, it is not a distance unit. It's a no units. For example, it's like a number, like 9 or 10, for example. In fact, I'll type in 10. We'll say OK, and we now have a new parameter called quantity. Let's go ahead and create our rectangular pattern. We'll pick on the circle. And instead of a quantity of 3, I'm going to come in here and start typing in QTY. And sure enough, we can see the quantity parameter in there. And we now have 10 circles. Now, we don't know what the spacing is yet, so we'll come back to that here in just a second. So I'm going to go ahead and say OK. And let's throw down some dimensions. So I want to create a dimension between these two circles. But notice what happens when I place the dimension. It says that it will over-constrain the sketch. And that's because the distance between these circles is actually being defined in the pattern. So it's going to create what's called a driven dimension instead. And we can see that by the parentheses. I'm going to go ahead and create a dimension between the edge and the center of that circle. Now, I want to have this dimension be the same as this other one, so I'm just going to click on this other dimension to reference it. And when I hit enter, you'll notice that they are now equal, or they're the same. So now we have equally spaced holes that go, you know, the length of this part. However, you'll notice that the one on the end isn't in the correct location. So let's go ahead and edit our pattern. And right now it's just some random number for the distance. Well, let's use some math to figure this out. We do know the total distance, which is length. So I'm going to go ahead and type in length, but you'll notice if I zoom out here, now it's spacing the circles the distance of length, which in this case is 6 inches. Well, let's go ahead and divide the length by the quantity of holes. Now it's a little kind of hard to see in the preview. I'm going to go ahead and just say OK. And now you can see that we have 10 holes that are equally spaced and they're the same distance from the edge. However, there's this hole over here. So let's go back into our pattern, and we need to basically make it so this circle isn't here. We still want the quantity of 10. Here's another neat little tip. You'll notice it says quantity. If I click on the little FX right next to it, I can see what that result is. And if I click on it again, it goes back to the original parameter. Same thing with this one here. You can kind of see just by clicking on it, it allows me to see the distance or what the variable is. So for the distance, let's go ahead and I'm going to put quantity plus 1 in here. So I'm going to say plus 1. But that's giving me a weird result. Well, and that's because it's doing the first order of operation. So it's taking length and it's dividing it by quantity and then adding 1 to that. What I want is I want the length divided by quantity plus 1 more. So I'm going to put this in parentheses like so. I can kind of see the preview update. I'll go ahead and say OK. And we now have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So the quantity of 10 holes. They're equally spaced and they're equally distanced from the edges. And what's nice about this is if I come back and change some variables here, so we change the length from 6 to 8, you'll see that those distances update. We still have 10 holes. I could come in here and make, let's just say, 6 holes, for example, and you can see how everything is updating accordingly. So, hopefully you all learned something new with that tip. If you want your question or topic on the next Banter with Brad, please email them to me at bradtallis@nextgensolutions.com. And I look forward to seeing you on the next Banter with Brad. Thank you.